flat out like a lizard drinking.
Happy as a dog with two tails.
Couldn't organise a fart in a curry factory.
Better than a poke in the eye with a sharp stick.
So bucktooth, she could eat a watermelon through a barbed wire fence.
They're like bank accounts. You have to have a lot of money to generate any interest.
Uglier than a hat full of... Oh, g'day. Welcome to Evention. I'm your host, Dom Schramm, with my wife, Jimmy. We were just going over some analogies. But today, we've put together some horse analogies to help you improve your riding. Analogies are really useful with horse riding. As riders, they help us paint a very clear mental picture of what we're trying to make it all look like. So we've put together some of our favorite analogies to help you improve your riding. Okay, number one, toes up. We've all heard instructor in the corner of the arena yelling, heels down, heels down. Sometimes by thinking bringing your toes up actually gets the same result, but it's in a fresher way. Number two, the hinge analogy. Gripping with your knee whilst jumping is a really dangerous thing to do. If you imagine we drilled a hole through there and put a hinge right through the horse, if that's your pivot point, if you were to become unseated, we're really unstable. Instead, think about creating your hinge or your pivot point down a lot lower by putting a rod through down your lower leg. That way, when you tip forward, your leg doesn't swing back. Okay, number three is my building analogy. Imagine you as the rider, like a building, and the top of the horse is ground level. Now, we know that any building needs to have supports into the ground, and that's basically what our leg is. So if your lower leg is insecure and flapping around, chances are your building's not very stable. Keep those deep pylons nice and stable and strong, and your building will be able to withstand even the roughest storm. Okay, number four is the triangle analogy. Imagine that someone's got a sticker and they've put a sticker dot about where your belly button is on the front of each shoulder. If you were to join those three stickers together, you'd make like a triangle. And when you're riding, especially in the dressage, think about making that triangle wider and taller. Number five is the tray analogy. When you're holding your hands, imagine you're holding a tray with a couple of cups of coffee on it. That gives you the idea of how spaced apart they need to be, as well as keeping them nice and still so you don't spill your coffee. Number six is the string analogy. Imagine there's a string coming out the very top of your head, pulling your spine nice and tall. That'll help give you that nice, tall, stable look. We're up to number seven. I like to call this one the posh spice. When we're riding, rather than looking down, we've got to keep our head up and look down our nose. Number eight, the bouncy ball. When we're riding dressage, we want to think like our legs are wrapping around a giant bouncy ball and we're squeezing it up underneath us. That helps us get the idea of collecting the horse underneath our body. Okay, our next to last, number nine. This is the angles analogy. Imagining we were in a jump tack, we can divide our lower leg up into three angles. The angle in our ankle, the angle in our knee, and the angle in our hip. As we go over a jump and the horse gathers himself up, picture that these three angles close, and then as we land, they open again, and that helps us get that shock absorber action that helps keep us soft on the horse's back over jump. Okay, last but not least, guys, number 10, the disappearing horse analogy. Anytime we're riding, whether it's flat work or jumping, we need to imagine that if we took the horse away all of a sudden, that we would always land on our feet. This helps us think about being a more balanced rider. We hope some of these analogies will be useful to you. We would love to hear some of your favorite ones on our Facebook page. Anyways, best of luck to you, and hopefully by using these, the next time you go in the ring, you'll be looking as flash as a rat with gold teeth. See ya.